Yes. That Nick Patrick's Day theme got me rocking and rolling and ready to throw down. But instead of fighting a stranger on the street, I will host the Pro Wrestling Potluck. Welcome to the show. I am your host, Scotland Green. This is the live weekly wrestling mixtape that I host every Thursday night on Twitch. Later on, it goes out to YouTube. This is a special episode. You see, I do this show every week, and I get submissions, and I build a show, and sometimes it makes no sense. There's little themes, maybe five themes running through. Sometimes it's just completely random, and then sometimes I have a gimmick episode, baby, and that's what we got tonight. We got Nick Patrick's Day, celebrating the referee Nick Patrick, and I've also been sent a ton of Irish-related videos for some reason, and we'll be watching some of those tonight. Also, I got sent so many Fit Finley matches that I put them on a wheel. We have the Wheel of Finley coming out tonight, debuting tonight. A lot of great matches on there. I had a couple sitting around, so I threw them on the wheel as well. So we got a full wheel, full show, full heart. Hello, chat. The chat is there. The chat's the best. That's the best way to watch the show. If I wasn't hosting, I would be in the chat, my friends. Yeah, get in the chat. The chat's great. And, what time is it now? It's everyone's favorite time of the show. It's the beginning. The largest frozen mug in the world is here. And I'm drinking some green stuff. Just regular old swag Mountain Dew tonight. Let's see. Let's turn this music down because, folks, it's potluck. ASMR. Let's see. Get that going. Let's see if this... Potluck. ASMR. All right, so there you go. That's the ASMR for tonight. I should be putting that out as its own video. It should just be its own account, where I'm just like... All right, what's everybody drinking tonight? Let me know in the chat. St. Patrick's Day is coming up, and guess what? I got no ties to St. Patrick's Day, believe it or not. I haven't drank in over 7 years, and my first name is Scotland, not Ireland, so I don't, you know, it don't mean very much to me. But, let's do it. Let's do it. We got a good one. You know, I do Christmas. Does Christmas mean a lot to me? I don't know. You know, I have... introduced myself to people and said, my name is Scotland Green, and they'll say, oh, that's a cute name, it sounds Irish. That's happened more than once. Iced tea, Moroccan mint. All right, we should start. Let's get the fun going, right? Enough of the non-fun. This is the non-fun part, when I babble up top and pour a drink into a microphone and babble. Just babble. My producer Sabrina's giving me the wrap it up sign that the cats do. All right. Well, enough. Enough, I say. Later on, not enough. Let me explain more. Later on, I'll be taking your calls. Hello. And we'll be doing two things. You got two options when you call, so you gotta call. One, the topic of the day is, who is the luckiest person in pro wrestling? I got some great answers on Instagram that I'll share, and I want to hear from you, because you're funny and interesting, and I think we'll have fun on the phone together, right? All right, just pal talk. And the second thing is, we got a tournament going all month long, the Gauntlet of Gimmicks. We're trying to find gimmicks that have never happened. You know, or a little twist on a gimmick. So keep those coming. I'm filling up the brackets. But if you got another gimmick, toss it out. I'm filling them up. I got a lot on Instagram and YouTube and other things. I got about 20-something out of 32. So I'm about to start putting them in the brackets, and then we'll be voting on Instagram. So get with it. And we'll talk about that later when I do the calls. For now, Let's do it. Let's all turn our keys at the same time and have some action in our lives.
Senior official Nick Patrick is now joining me. And Nick, obviously, if you take a look back,
the reason for the season,
like we just did, some pretty incriminating stuff. And you go back from actually began at Hog Wild and even this past Monday on Nitro with the belt and Diamond Dallas. Some fishy things are going on. I've not ever been the one to accuse you of anything, but I do need to ask you point blank. Are you being paid off in any way? Are you part of this incursion by the New World Order?
Absolutely not, Tony. I've been with WCW now for 8 years. This is the first time ever anyone has ever questioned my integrity in 8 years. Now why
Nick
all of a sudden
Patrick.
Is my integrity being questioned? You know, I was watching all the television shows that WCW put out over the past weekend, and there's been a lot of things going on in the past few weeks, but I got a question I'd like to ask you, Tony. Did you or did
Nick,
you not
Nick
hear Hulk Hogan give up? That's a big question.
Damn neck brace on his cock.
Well, I thought he did give up, as a matter of fact, but I really wasn't sure. As a matter of fact,
that's
he grabbed Randy Anderson right at the time. Just about the time I thought I heard him say give up, he grabbed Randy Anderson and threw him out. So really, I'm not sure.
Well, now, if he give up, if that's true, and Ric Flair didn't win the title right then, instead, it was called a disqualification because the outsiders hit the ring. Wouldn't you say that's a lot more controversial cause than anything that I've been involved with in the last few weeks?
I'll give it to you right there. But, you know, there's a lot of controversial things going on in WCW. You know, it's really got to be tough being out there.
That's true. There's a lot of controversy going on right now in WCW. What do you have when you don't have law and order and discipline? You have anarchy. And it's my job to make sure that that doesn't happen here in WCW. It's also Randy Anderson's job. And my name over the past few weeks has been slandered terribly by Gene Okerlund, mainly Gene Okerlund. Now, I've listened to your commentary. You've been pretty fair, and you've given me a reason to doubt. Gene Okerlund has been on my case hard. And if you ask me, where does Gene Okerlund come from? What's he been here, 2 years? I know he goes way back with these guys, the outsiders. If I was you people, I'd take a little closer look at Gene Okerlund and not be pointing your finger so much at me.
I was just thinking the same thing, Brian. Like, do they need this crowd noise?
Let me in. Who are you? I will run right through you. Who am I? Let me in.
Yeah, I'm just going to call security.
No, you're not going
to
call security, you stupid dope. I will freaking dance on your head. I need to see Wendy Rose.
Now without an appointment.
You tell Wendy Rhodes to get out of her little office right now before I go back
this
there.
This is billions.
I told you never to come to my place of work.
You're going
exactly.
to have to throw me in.
Whoa. 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 All right. Is she going to do a move? Or is she just selling? Is that Dan Soder?
Whoa!
Kip up. On billions. That wasn't Dan Soder. Or no, it is Dan
Max
Soder.
Capital. Mace Cap. I give you the champion of the world. The man, Becky Lynch.
Wait, she plays herself? That's cheating.
Now, none of yous know this because Wendy over here keeps her mouth shut, but when I was in my low and lost period in my life...
Oh. All right, enough promos. After this, we're spinning the wheel for our first Finley match. First of probably two. After this promo, this whatever, this hilarious ad.
Chuck? Yeah, there's someone here for you.
Hey, I heard there was someone here to see me. Sorry, I was just a bit busy. I was on the phone.
Do you know what? With his nose, he just snorting dope.
Hey, you must be.
Andrew Healing's
Big
in
Dave,
the house.
What's up? Nice to meet you. Right. I mean, if it's not a rude question, what are you working on there? Kill.
None of your business. Oh. What's working there?
Right. Okay. I mean, who do you want to
it's
see
not the
me?
Voice I expected.
Well, you know.
I hear you're the man I need to talk to about the WCPW Championship.
Oh, this is really awkward. I mean, if you'd got in contact a week earlier or something, that would have been far better, because it's really awkward, but I've already
that
got
like a child.
Guy.
Well, now you've got a new guy.
Throw that child out the window. Cosplay Ryback should go on our gimmick list. Alright, let's go to the wheel. Let's go to the freaking wheel. We'll come back to you, Nick Patrick. It is your day, after all, the reason for the GD season. Alright.
And I love to fight.
Alright, look at this wheel. I might need to move the chat. The chat is blocking the wheel. But this is a beautiful thing. I was sent many Finley matches, and I have a few myself, so... why not? The great potluck tradition of having too many things, an embarrassment of riches. So I put them on the wheel, and we will spin the wheel. And all right. You know what? Let's move the chat. Let's put this over. There's not a good place for it, but that's okay. We're not going to be on this screen very long anyway. Clint's in the house. Hell yeah. My oldest and dearest friend, Clint, who makes the potluck logo. All right. Now look at the... it's going on a very... yeah, it's a leisurely spin right now until I click on it. And I'm about to click on it, folks. We've heard enough of this music. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Okay. Spin! Hey, Dean Malenko! There you go. No whammies. We got Fit Finley versus Dean Malenko coming up right after...
Jealousy I sense there, Larry Zbysko?
I'm trying to remember who sent this in. It might have been Henrik, YouTube viewer Henrik, who's been really stepping up to the plate. Shout out to Henrik, sending in stuff, the good stuff every week. I love when people send stuff in, it gets used, and they want to send in more, and I love it. So shout out to Henrik, who I think sent this in. If not, it was Dr. Liam. Crimson Mask Replica on Instagram, one of the great accounts.
Yeah, it just seems more than a coincidence that for 3 weeks in a row, every time there's been a Dean Malenko matchup, that you've been out here making your presence felt, Eddie.
Tony, mind your own business. That was Mike.
This was sent in by Henry, because I remember he gave me this note that the referee for this Finley match is Nick Patrick, keeping with Nick Patrick's day, our theme. Look at Eddie Guerrero with his dry hair. It looks so weird.
Put him back on.
All right, now he's back all with us. Why don't you go to the ring?
Right, I mean, we got Nick Patrick, referee, and Dean Malenko, the damn Iceman versus the Belfast Bruiser,
kind of
Fit Finley.
About,
double
ring.
Theme, look, everybody drink. You said
Fit
it,
Finley
Andrew
right
Heelan.
He does. Gotta say, the man is awesome. Fit Finley, look at that wrestler. What a wrestler. What
Hogan fears Nez. Really is that about Michael Nesmith?
As a matter of fact, I really
my
think
favorite
movie.
RIP, Mike Nesmith.
Coming over here from Belfast, Ireland. I think one of the most physical wrestlers ever to hit the States, Eddie.
Well, not only that, he outclassed Dean Malenko all the way. I mean, in every aspect, Fit Finley just is better than Dean Malenko.
Well, I know he's good, and I know Dean Malenko is good. They're both great, but to say that he outclassed, you're making this personal for you and Dean Malenko.
Wow, I'm glad this was the first Finley match off the wheel. This is perfect.
Tons of class. I mean, he's the Iceman. He has held the Cruiserweight and U.S. titles in a short span. He has been every bit as successful.
And I didn't screw with the odds. I could have screwed with the odds, but why would I? I leave it up to fate. I leave it up to God.
And saying it's my fault for him losing the Cruiserweight title, and it's my fault for him losing the United States title.
And Larry, let's agree with one thing as we see Fit Finley stomp the side of the head of Dean Malenko. It wasn't too long ago, we'll recall on this program, that Dean Malenko and Eddie Guerrero were tag team partners. And that didn't last long, now did it?
No, not really. Well, you know, I traveled with Dean on the road a lot. And wrestling with him is kind of the same thing of, you know, traveling with him is... It's kind of boring.
I've heard the same thing.
You know, the man has no expression. I mean, you ask him if you want where he wants to eat dinner, he can't reply nothing. You ask him if he wants to go work out, he just turns around and looks at you with that dumb face of his.
Referee Vinny Lax in the house. It's good to have a ref here for Nick Patrick's Day. Shout out to the officials all over the world, keeping law and order in a lawless world.
Hey, listen, everybody wanted to see the frog splash, and he had to stick in his nose, you know, took advantage of the situation that I had everybody beat, came in and hogged up the glory with his Texas cloverleaf move.
I don't know. It was a tag team.
That's a hard question. Best mullet. I got to give it to Finley. Even though, you know, if we're talking about this segment, we got Eddie Guerrero with the poofy dry mullet. Looking like goddamn Farrah Fawcett.
In the professional wrestling ring, that makes for interesting bedfellows.
It really does. And let's add this one into it. And you know it as well as I do, Champ Guerrero. Here's a cover. The fact that there is a replay of this program immediately following when we take the air. So Dean Malenko watches this. Dean Malenko has heard what you have
Crooked
said.
Crooked ref is such a great concept.
Knowing Dean Malenko,
must be so much fun to play a man who will always accept ref.
The challenge. I'm sure we're going to hear from Dean Malenko.
Finley just snatching Dean by the head and just being like, all right, I'm going outside the ring now.
You know, doesn't know what to say. Just like I say, looks around with that glazy look and goes, I don't know.
What does your mom think of the way you've been acting over the past year?
Ooh, hits it hard. I see it bend. He hit it sideways.
I don't know. Ask the
Dean Malenko, number one of PWI's top 500 in 1997.
This expressionless man you're talking about, the Iceman Dean Malenko, is really taking some punishment to Fit Finley.
You know, the man has no expression, you know.
Yes, he has no expression.
And sometimes no expression. Oh, shit, Dean, whoa.
What a move by Finley that time, rolling through, catching Malenko in the head.
Now there, Finley. I saw a little bit of expression on his face, kind of like a surprise expression, kind of like maybe the same kind of expression he had if his wife were to tell him they were going to have twins or something like that.
Eddie, I just don't understand.
Yeah, this crowd's waiting for Hulk Hogan to come out and play the belt like a
competing for the same championship
like a fucking guitar.
To just this out and out, just utter disdain that you
the
have
only
for the
kind
man.
Of respect that I have for the man is that he can keep a straight face when somebody's telling a joke.
They might make an appearance. Actually, because they were both in the little opening. They both had their names in the opening, so they'll be on the show in some form or fashion.
As he goes along in the ring, there's a cover and he got a two count. You know,
Dean Malenko's really lucky to kick out of that.
Dean Malenko's a great athlete. Great athletes kick out of moves like that.
Dean holds on.
Well, he hit the ropes that time.
No.
Great counter move by Malenko, hooking the top rope.
Ducked, good go behind, back elbow, Dean Malenko. Breaking loose from that hold. Malenko. Takes him over one.
Kick out two.
Where's he going?
Well, I couldn't help.
Where's he going?
And through the headsets
why
now.
Don't we just count
that's my favorite thing in commentary. Well, where's he going? You know where he's going. You know exactly where he's going.
Sound, but Eddie Guerrero right now is stalking to the ring as we almost had a three again.
Roll up by Malenko. Nets him just a two count against Finley. And you're right, Eddie Guerrero is headed to ringside.
Yes, Malenko, if Malenko sees this guy, I mean, This is what Guerrero wants to do. He wants Malenko to see him in the match with Finley. Malenko nails.
I'm sorry that I said Eddie has Farrah Fawcett hair. He has Courtney Cox hair.
Once again, I think Guerrero realizes that this Iceman, he's up on the apron. And Dean Malenko caught it. He caught Eddie Guerrero.
Get his ass, Finley.
Finley caught Dean Malenko. Oh, my.
Sure, Malenko left himself wide open for the attack from behind by Finley, even though he delivered the forearm smash to Guerrero.
See, now when you ask Guerrero how his mouth got all beat up, he can say, I don't know.
Well, I certainly hope he doesn't come back over here.
Here's shit.
Fit Finley. Ooh. Him down with a pile driver. Covers 1-2. He's not going to get out. Fit Finley defeats Dean Malenko thanks to help from Eddie Guerrero.
Fit Finley getting a win.
From Eddie Guerrero. Leading
Nick
to
Patrick
Finley, spiking Malenko with the pile driver in the pin.
So Fit Finley, tough as they come in our sport, gets another win. And fans, we want to remind you, still to come, Eddie Guerrero will wrestle the Ultimo Dragon and much more live on 3 hours of Nitro. Stay with us.
All right.
American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. On
more
WCW
Nick Patrick.
Saturday night.
It is his day.
Rather alarming for me to see Tony Schiavone last week conduct an interview with this man. He is the senior official at World Championship Wrestling. Nick Patrick, come on in. First of all, I want to qualify any of the statements I say on this or any other television program. In many cases, I play the devil's advocate. But somebody has got to be bringing up these coincidences.
3 hours of Nitro is
if it weren't for me, perhaps nobody would say anything. But you've got to be called. And especially in light of what just happened recently in that match involving Big Bubba Rogers.
Everything that has happened in the ring, there's always been on film, and they have been able to clear me every time. But I have been slandered in the last few weeks by
you
yourself.
You have been slandered?
Yes, I have been slandered by you. I've listened to every one of the WCW shows. You and Dusty Rhodes have been all over me. Now, we all know where Dusty Rhodes' loyalties really lie and why. But you go back with the Outsiders a whole lot further than I do.
I don't think we should start talking about me. Let's talk about you, Nick Patrick. I know your family. I know your father. I know your family ties and everything to this great sport. And in many instances, you have to do what you have to do. I'm just saying there's been a lot of questionable calls that involve you and no other official.
Well, first off, right now, I want to put an end to some of the lies that's been said about me. I do not have a new sports car.
Can you imagine this is a silent movie? The card comes up. Car.
I've lived in the same house for 5 years, and it appraises somewhere between 125 and 150. It's not an extravagant house.
All right. Well, I mean, I did bring up these things because I happen to see you in a new sports car, and I did see you in some Giorgio Armani clothing, and that probably was just another coincidence, too.
Well, I'll tell you what's a coincidence. I got to the building here early today, and I saw you pull up in a brand-new, beautiful, nice red Mercedes.
Oh, but that's not mine. That's a rental car, and it's not a Mercedes.
They're all getting paid by Turner. Why are they shaming each other for making money?
Stay tuned more Saturday night when we come back.
Well, he got him up high right there. He looks good. He can't make a mistake right now. Here's a pin for the cover.
What? I'm not doing that yet. I'm going to go to this screen. This is a good time to tell you this. Future potluck plans, because they just reminded me. 2 weeks from now will be the Save My YouTube episode of Potluck. It's going to be great. We're going to have subjects that would be good on YouTube, like, let's say, cats, financial things, whatever. Send me some submissions and ideas. And for the main event of the YouTube episode in 2 weeks, I will eat a hot chip or a hot gummy bear, one of those hottest gummy bears in the world things. I will eat one in the main event and cry and all that stuff because I'm desperate. So that's and I'll have more to say about the YouTube episode. It will be a fun one, but next week, that's why I did it the main event, because I think if I did it in the middle of the show, it would be like, hey, I'm gonna cancel the rest of the show because I'm sick. So I'm putting it in the main event just in case. So 2 weeks from now is the Save My YouTube episode of the show. And next week, what are we doing next week? It's Potluck Mall Madness. Next week on Potluck will be a mall gimmick show to celebrate American Coliseum Wrestling, the company I work for in Haverstraw, New York. where I'm the ring announcer and the general manager. We will be at the American Dream Mall in New Jersey on the 23rd of March. So on potluck on March 21st, we will have a Mall Madness gimmick show. I've already gotten a lot of great submissions of all stripes, so I might even be good on submissions, but if you got some weird things, send them on over. Few people have stepped up mightily for the Mall Madness episode. Of course, Crimson Mask replica himself, Dr. Liam, and Brett Davis has sent me a lot of great stuff too. So it will be wonderful. All right, so that's that. I wanted to make that announcement now before I forget. So let's get to it. Get to what? Oh. Get to this.
Got a two count, kick in the back of the head. Chris Jericho cuts off.
This is a very WCW show. This will make not that Tom Green blush. There's so much WCW on this show. And if you don't know, he's the man who does WCW deep cuts on Tuesday night. We are the bootleg cousins. Tuesday night, WCW deep cuts with not that Tom Green. Check it out. I'm there when I can be in the chat cutting up.
Of course he was.
Saw the feet and still made the three count. And Jericho empowers Teddy Long there, irate.
What I'm trying to tell you is how can you sit down and count one, two, three,
testify.
And the guy's feet are on the rope?
Testify.
Tell me that.
Don't you think, as long as I've been refereed, if a man's feet are on the rope, that I would have seen it?
Three gimmick shows in a row, baby.
With your track record as an official, Teddy Long.
Hey,
you think about that for a while, mister.
You know, I'm going to try to get Nick Patrick. Get
let me
here.
Interview him.
Now, let me do it. Let me talk to him. You may give him an elbow or something.
No, man, I'm going to tell you what. You see, right?
Yeah, so I'm
nice
in Haverstraw all the time, and you know, once a month or whatever. This show's going to be
now
in New Jersey in the second biggest mall in the country, the Great American The American Dream Mall. Oh my God. I'm going to get fired.
Tony Schiavone.
The American Dream
Mall.
Want
to get over and chat with him. Ask him what he was looking at. Go ahead, Tony.
All right, Dream. Thanks a lot. Nick Patrick, come on
more
in here
Nick
if
Patrick
you will.
For us
you know, I've tried to be
Nick
very
Patrick's
fair to you.
Day.
Some people have not. But it was pretty apparent to me, at least I thought, that you looked up and saw the feet on the ropes but still made the three count. Can you answer that?
That's ridiculous. Don't you think as long as I've been refereeing, if the man's feet would have been on the ropes, I would have seen that and I would have called that. But I do have a few things that I want to clear up while I'm out here since you did invite me out here.
It is the mall
the
by
one
MetLife.
Thing that
it's a very strange
the most
mall.
Damage to WCW
I went to
at War Games. You know what that one thing
around.
Was?
What was that, Nick?
That one thing was the rumor that Sting had turned NWO. And you know who spread that rumor?
Well, I know a lot of people did.
Well, you're the main one that I heard spreading that rumor. And there's another thing I'd like to get straight. I listen to the commentary an awful lot, and I've heard Dusty Rhodes saying that I've sold my soul to NWO. Well, that's another blatant lie. I am WCW all the way, and I proved that at the last Nitro when everybody walked out.
Slander
all the WCW people turned and run like cowards. All the announcers, even so-called head referee Randy Anderson, he pulled off his tie and he was out of there. But who's the man that stayed and made sure that law and order was carried out for the rest of the evening? Who's the one man that had the guts to stand up and face these guys off? Referee Nick Patrick. I want to say one thing to all you WCW fans out there. As long as I'm here, you don't have a thing to worry about.
Okay.
We'll be back.
We'll be back.
Giant Haystack stands nearly 7 feet tall, weighs 32 stone, and reportedly eats a breakfast of 6 eggs, half a pound of bacon, a loaf of bread, and 2 pints of milk.
Now I think Dr. Liam
His
sent
opponent
this one in.
In Enniskillen before a record crowd of 2,000 was Jack Flash Sherlock, Irish lightweight champion. Strangling your opponent seems par for the course, and if the ref gets in the way... But it's not all fun and theatrics. On this occasion, the scheduled 8-round contest was stopped by the referee after 3 because of a bleeding head wound to Sherlock. Giant Haystacks is in County Louth tomorrow night for his one trip across the board.
Well, more Nick Patrick. We're getting right to it. And we're going to spin the Finley wheel again, folks.
To be very honest with you, the fans enjoy what the Macho Man did a week ago right here on Saturday night.
Well, I'm sorry if the fans enjoyed that, but let's talk a little bit right now about what's going on in the world of sports. You noticed here recently in baseball that one of the baseball players got out of line and attacked an official. Now all the baseball officials are boycotting baseball. I think that's a brilliant move by the officials of baseball, and that's exactly what I'm doing right here tonight. I am calling on Randy Anderson and Mark Curtis. We need to boycott WCW unless they are going to stand behind us. Now, I'm out here. This is going to be a shock to the world because I am going to take control here, and I'm going to bring law and order back to WCW, and I'm going to do it by making this move right here, right now. The largest fine ever levied in any professional sports is right now being levied against the Macho Man, Randy Savage, for placing his hands upon me. $1 million is the fine that I am setting down on Macho Man Randy Savage for putting his hands on me, and I am also pushing for him to be suspended. Now, I've been assured by my lawyers that I have a very, very good case, and I suggest that WCW back me up on this, because if you'll notice, there was one announcer out here that stirred up a lot of trouble and spread a lot of lies and a lot of rumors about me. And if you'll notice, that man's not here anymore, is he?
All right, some very...
yeah, he's got power somehow.
And what a fine levied that he suggests...
he can do $1 million fine.
Fans will have more on Saturday night.
All right. Oh, hey. All right, we're gonna spin this Finley wheel again. Why not? Why not? There he goes. Finley versus Danny Boy Collins in a chain match. I believe Dr. Liam sent this one in. I will dig this up and I'll be right back.
Bottom wrist lock, lateral drop into a head scissors by Wrestling 2. Tenru trapped in that head scissors now.
There's a woman in a headdress. What is this? Is this Burning Man? A white lady in a headdress? Is this Burning Man? I say again. Oh, Finley's wife.
Mae'na faner yng Nghornel Finley ac mae'na faner yng Nghornel Danny Boy Collins. A tasg y naill fel y llall ydy camu I gornel y gwrthwynebydd.
Okay, this is not English and I'm not having a stroke. It's like, I understand every sixth word. Is everything okay? Did I drink my Mountain Dew too fast?
Down wrestler. Symud neidio taflu.
Welch.
Ar weitha'r ffaith bod yr hwymyn yn dal y ddau.
So that's Finley's wife in the headdress.
A dyma chi gam ddefnydd o'r hwymyn. Oh. A di hwnnw ddim yn ddarlun pert. Chico Roberts yn gwneud I ore.
Oh, they're only married for a short time. His ex-wife. chain across the eyes of Danny Boy Collins. This is tripping me out that it's not in English, for real. It took me a second. Finley's mullet here is beautiful. The curls at the end, it really is a beautiful thing. Finley whipping him with the chain now. Danny Boy Collins. Oh, Danny Boy. I don't need to mute it. I'll just talk over it. Point of the elbow to the head of Danny Boy Collins. Ooh, boot. Danny's in trouble. He's on the ground. Chain to the head. Ooh, stretches the chain over his knee and drops it onto the forehead. Danny Boy Collins is not getting much in. Oof. Collins getting whooped. Now whipped with the chain. Danny Boy Collins getting choked. Just foaming at the mouth. Danny Boy. Another elbow to the face of Collins, who has gotten very little offense. Bit drops the elbow. Love this old man referee. Looks like a pro bowler. Ooh, Danny, coming back, tug of war. Hey, wait a second. Finley and his bride, who's dressed like somebody from Urban Outfitters, with the level of cultural appropriation. He's climbing up. What are you climbing? Wait, what is that? What is going on? Coachella, thank you. Coachella tops everything that I was saying. Capture the flag, chain match. Is that a flag? Yeah, I guess so. Ooh, Finley pulled off. Hits hard. The Welsh flag. See, this is why the chat is so good. Well, I know nothing. Danny Boy coming back. Ooh, a kick staggers Finley, who falls out of the ring.
Collins and Dangos Donye Cyffrous. Ac mae'n gymaint o sôn am Danny Boy Collins. Mae'n cael ei enwi fel gobaith.
That is the world's thinnest referee.
Yn bencampwr pwysau welter, Prydain ac Ewrop.
Baseball slide.
Ac yn medru dal i dir yn erbyn y goreion. A beth bynnag i'ch barn
chi am ydych chi'n gyfo,
mae Fit Finley yn un o'r goreion. Mae Dewis Hoges yn cyfarwyddyd yn cyhyddo Fit Finley o ddiogi.
You don't want Fit to have control of your head.
Ac o Adeli Collins fanteisio nawr te.
Big chop, no chain necessary on that, but back to choking him. Danny Boy's making frog faces there, like John Moxley, the master of the frog face. I love this ancient referee.
Did Collins have got Ian Kevle?
I bet that referee does do darts announcing. Head first. Love an old ref. I love a ref that needs help getting up. And looks mad every time he has to count and then get back up. That's my kind of ref. Finley getting choked now. It's a stop to it. Chain to the face.
Now Dewis Hoges eto yn cynferiogi y dorf yma. Ond mae yna bobl sy'n fodlon teithio'n bell i weld Fit Finley. Roedd yn amateur.
Scoop and a slam. Danny Boy back down on the canvas. Finley going for that flag. The chain is between his legs though. A chain right in his asshole. Oh, my God. Necro Eric, I'm right there with you. I thought I was having a stroke for the first 60 seconds of this match. Finley with a chain going across his eyes. Danny Boy Collins fighting for his life in there. Miss Coachella herself watches, worried about her man, Fit Finley, in this chain flag match.
Macarweitha Mantes Bendant Finley. Mark Collins wedi dangos donie ar brydie.
It's Welsh. That's what they say. Now Danny Boy making his way to the top, making his way to the flagpole. Oh my God. Danny Boy. Danny Boy, Davey Boy, if I was a wrestler, I would not want Boy in my name in any way. Oh, fuck! Jesus, suplex him to the outside, the chain somewhere in the middle. Ooh, nice clothesline from Collins. Finley down, Collins. I keep thinking they're gonna do something off the top rope, but they're just going for the flag. Ooh, dropped him. Yeah, Bad Boy's a little different, I guess, than just being like Danny Boy. Oof. Oh, shit. Finley tumbles outside, finds himself a chair, and Miss Coachella nearby. Oof. Danny Boy comes a tumbling. Back first across the pole. The boy, Scotland Green. That's a boy, Scotland Green. Finley wins. You know what I was thinking of doing as a heel ring announcer? I was thinking of telling people, why are you booing me? I'm a nice guy. I want to be a nice guy. One of those guys who says they're a nice guy, you know? They're awful.
Let's roll, please.
Raw Payne's been on USA Network as well as WWE Monday Night Raw. You know, we're both got a family here.
Here's
USA Network to be on the TV program. It's a great opportunity, and I'm very excited about it.
It's awesome to have Sheamus out here. I am a huge fan of the WWE.
How are you doing? How are you, Mark? How are you doing? I met you before. I met you every camera.
Yes. Yeah. That's right. Well, I got to host Raw.
Who's he pinning?
Are you excited to be here? I'm delighted to be here. Yeah, I'm really excited.
In Sheamus's contract, one of the sentences was like, I have to tone down my whole body so he feels less insecure.
I'm watching you guys put together the scenes.
We're very, cool. Very good. I'm sure he's going to be awesome.
Yeah, I can tell. I can tell, yeah.
We're going to have a great time. The one amazing thing about Sheamus's contract is it also said instigate as many fights between Sheamus and Mark as possible. Just say, I really, really want you guys to fight.
That Mark guy was sure in Knucklehead, which we watched on the Hot Luckos Hollywood episode on YouTube, one of my favorite episodes.
I was just kind of like an upper body guy, and I would kind of like.
I was in Knucklehead as an extra. Check out the Hot Luckos Hollywood episode if you don't know that story.
Mark and I, who play brothers, are going to skinny dip. We have to wear these bikinis, which are actually more humiliating than nakedness. And I jump in that pool of some big action star played by Sheamus.
Oi, what's going on?
Oi.
Who are you?
I Hank.
Get the hell out of my pool!
It's great. It's shit with the two lads in the pool.
It happens all the time.
Get the hell out of my pool! Get the hell out of my pool!
Guys, get the hell out of my pool! That's a wrap on Sheamus, guys. And everybody's like, thank God. I hate when
experience, and I've learned
USA forces us to use wrestlers.
And, you know, this is something I'd love to do down the road. Maybe I'd love to do a lot more TV shows or even get into movies.
Sheamus has been so wonderful in the short time that I've gotten to know him. To be honest, I hope the acting bug bites him. He has potential to, you know, go and entertain a lot of people and do what he loves most. You know,
flex that body.
Oh, God.
I know, watch some total divas. Yeah, Razor Gem. There might be some on this show.
Thank you for doing our show.
Thanks, everybody, for having me.
You'd have to pay me to watch Royal Pains. Pay me. What's next? Oh, my God.
We have seen the footage from this past Monday on Nitro, Mr. Patrick.
$100 per episode.
Mr. Carr, but I think it's very obvious
of Royal
Pains,
once again, and I'll watch it.
You disqualify someone who did not deserve being disqualified in World Championship Wrestling.
First of all, Schiavone, how many times do we have Schiavone to do this? I am the legal counsel. You direct all questions to me. Is this too hard for you to understand?
It's not hard for me to understand, but isn't it apparent what's going on here?
Are you questioning 16 years of officiating expertise? I don't think so.
I don't think I'm the only one questioning 16 years of officiating. As a matter of fact, let's bring in Teddy Long and the man in question here, Chris Jericho. Whoa, hold on here. Wait a minute now.
See, this is the chat. This is why not that Tom Green is the host of WCW Deep Cuts. He says that guy is Alan Sharp, who's WCW's actual lawyer.
I say to you, Mr. Sharp, last week, you investigated my past. This week, I investigated your past. Isn't it true that your law firm is called Do We Cheat 'Em and How?
Wow.
I get it. Just the facts. Your daddy was a hockey goon, and you are simply a goon, Jericho.
Your daddy was a hockey goon.
And me and nobody else.
So it's between us, huh?
So what are we doing here?
Hey, let me say one thing right now. Let me clear the air. Nick Patrick, you know, and everybody else knows, that this young superstar could take one hand tied behind his back and beat you on any.
Now, who's the first person to use Dewey, Cheatham, and Howe? I always thought that was either a Looney Tunes joke or a Three Stooges joke or something.
A verbal binding agreement that Jericho will challenge my client, Nick Patrick, with one arm tied behind his back. Is that what you just
said? Is that it?
Wait a second, Teddy. You know what, Teddy? I think I can beat Nick Patrick with one hand tied behind my back. As a matter of fact, I know I can.
How about that, Mr. Patrick? Can I ask him this question?
Nick Patrick, how do you feel?
I feel like the real deal, Evander Holyfield. As a matter of fact...
Say what?
I think I've got the cure. My neck's starting to feel a little bit better already,
it's
Mr. Jericho.
A promo.
Well, I'm sure it is, finally, and I think we may have a match in the works, and we'll have more in just a moment on TBS.
All right, here we go. Let's see if this makes it to the YouTube cut. This is from World War III. We are knee-deep, some would say neck-deep, in WCW stuff tonight. Here he is, coming out for a match. Nick Patrick in a pay-per-view match, folks. He's got a robe like one of the Young Bucks. The Young Bucks have the same entrance as Nick Patrick in 1996. Ah, referee Vinny Lax says it was a Three Stooges joke first. Oh my God, remember this song? Old Jericho theme. This is a goddamn babyface theme. Chris Jericho with Teddy Long for some reason. I can't play TNA on this show. It doesn't make it to YouTube. TNA is bad news for Potluck. I wish I could play more TNA on this show. I would. Nick Patrick is tall. I know Vinny Lax said it earlier, but I don't think I realized.
He's wearing white. I haven't seen a paycheck. I haven't seen any real proof. I can't convict the man until I see some evidence.
You ever listen to any of the replays of these telecasts? The uncorked.
After this match, I'm going to be taking calls, folks.
I know sometimes it looks that way.
And listen to what you're saying.
Sometimes it looks that way. I will admit that. But we don't have any proof.
Scott Dickinson is WWE does not care for the most part. If it's already on YouTube, I can play it on the show for the most part. TNA, it doesn't matter if it's already on YouTube. They just don't let it happen. Tonight, there's two things you can call in about. You can call in about who is the luckiest person in pro wrestling. And I've got some, that's the primary thing. And then all month long, we're pitching gimmicks for the gauntlet of gimmicks, the gimmick gauntlet, trying to find pro wrestling gimmicks that haven't been done. So two reasons to call up tonight. And I'm going to read the list of some of these gimmicks I got. And maybe we'll try to figure out which one should go against each other when we vote in the bracket. All right, let's go, Nick Patrick.
Patrick attacks
Anderson looks back. And so far with one hand, two pretty good moves.
Hang on here, mister.
Now, referee Vinny Lax, when you had to tie someone's arm behind their back, did you practice it first before the match, or was it the first time you were doing it out there live in front of the nice people? I love how Nick Patrick is wearing the stripes, even though the official in this match is not wearing stripes. He's doing the old bow tie bit. He tested it first.
Let Nick Patrick come back into the ring.
Well, he's wishing good luck,
that's what it sounds like to me. Let me say this, too.
I'm sorry, that to me.
It's appeared to two of the three of us that Nick Patrick has been a part of this NWO for quite a while.
Without a doubt.
Been on the take, whatever you want to call it.
It's true.
Me and Dream, not you. So with that in mind, would Chris Jericho be safe tonight against Nick Patrick?
Well, we said that, you know,
Dublin Destroyer. If you had referee merch, that would be a great thing to put on referee merch. Counting to three is easy. Stopping at two is the tricky part. I like that. That's what I would be worried about as a referee. That's a lot of a lot of responsibility. Yeah, Nick Patrick is selling like hell.
You're not kidding. Here comes a hit out of the corner, one arm. And Jericho ahead of steam. Watch out.
Well, he's retreating again and taking a walk out here by us.
Nick Patrick looking straight up like Kenny Powers in this one.
Watch out. Most of the fans who have been watching Nick Patrick over the past couple of months. Go ahead, shut him down. Stomp on him.
Patrick's got to do something. He's got to get Jericho down. He's got to start working on that right hand. That's the only way he's going to beat him.
Yeah, that's true, but you can't, you know what I mean? You can't get, you know, Chris Jericho can't get lulled into this thing here because this guy is being a master.
I love that after all these years, Jericho is still not a good babyface. He's an obnoxious babyface. Taking all the other stuff, away. He's.
That's what to do. You've got to get Jericho, blind him. So you don't know what to do. You got to blind the man. Then go work on him.
Really stepping on his toes. Ah, the big clothesline that leveled him out.
We've made so much of the.
Patrick's down, flopping.
Jericho proving us wrong.
Like a striped fish out of water. The World War III three-ring thing is so goofy. Ooh, he hits the ring post, or even two. Ooh, now it's Jericho's turn to hit the steel. This was on pay-per-view. People paid to see this. Or they paid and then had to see this. And you're watching for free. And you, I guess, have to see this, or, you know, you don't have to.
Have you had a meeting with Eric Bischoff this week?
Pride, Tony, pride.
That's what I want to know.
I haven't had no meetings with anybody this week, or any week. It's my business if I...
Trust no one, especially the person sitting to your right. Would you believe that?
Nick Patrick in control now. Look at that. Shades of Shane Douglas.
Trying to get to his feet. Being helped up now by Patrick.
I wouldn't pick him up. I wouldn't have got him up. I'd have kept him down and worked on that arm.
Patrick, pretty good combination blows that time.
Yeah, right. But that blow, that right hand blow to the chin didn't have a real good effect on him. I don't think he's got a lot of power in that right hand. He's had a lot of steam taking him on the last 5-6 minutes.
Punk, I think is what he said.
Back to the attack again. He's allowing Jericho. See? He's allowing
yeah, I want to see, like, what this floor plan looks like. Because it's one thing to just see this, but there's two other rings somewhere. And some people have front row for one ring, and then the other rings are far away. Yeah, I have front row for the third ring. The one in the dark.
Finish him off right here. Get your deal done and get out of here.
Waste no time.
Patrick trying to escape.
He's out on his feet.
Jericho's got him by the hair. Holding on. Hits first turnbuckle repeatedly. Again. Again.
Well, that won't clear the cobwebs.
No, but that'll show me. They love the count to 10. They love it. The people.
I guarantee you.
I don't think he cares about pinning Nick Patrick. He doesn't want to win this match. That way. He wants to beat on him.
That's right. I don't think there's been an attempt of a pin here tonight. Unlike the first match where we saw.
Ooh. Scary back body drop. One arm.
I think Nick is going home.
One way or the other. Front door back. He's getting out of here.
That's right. Go home and see your daddy, Nick.
I'd get that rope.
Go home and see your daddy.
I tie him and keep
going. Go home and see your daddy, Nick.
That was a pretty smart move to get the advantage being the first man in the ring.
Well, if you've refereed all your life, you've seen never move and every dirty trick in the game. And lately, you've been pulling every dirty trick. So I guarantee you, you know what to do. When you've been in there with the greatest competitors of all time at WCW with a big ball play, you have seen it all.
Go home and see
your daddy.
Adding it to the list.
He wastes a long time getting up on top that time.
Be careful here now.
Oh, goodness. Jericho sitting down hard with one arm. And Jericho's waiting on him. Jericho, super kick.
Ooh.
He's got him right there. Go ahead and put him
come on, Nick. Grab the ropes.
Jericho
won with a super kick. Are you kidding me, brother?
Got him good. Remember this, McPatrick is not a wrestler. He is a referee.
Jericho's babyface music. Super kick to the heart. I've been there.
He may wake up. Chris Jericho, and I tell you, this match certainly.
Okay, look at that above level. Ooh, it looks terrible to be there live.
McPatrick had the advantage here for a short period of time. Put that right boot right in the mush. To his knees, face down. I'm not sure if I can do where he was.
All right. We'll be right back. I'll have the screen up. I'll get the Zoom ready. And we'll take some calls. Get in there, and we'll talk about the two topics. Who is the luckiest person in pro wrestling? And what gimmicks have never been done that you want to put in the brackets of the gauntlet of gimmicks? All right. Okay, let me test something real quick. All right, this should work. This should work. All right, we got two big topics tonight. The topic of the night is who is the luckiest person in pro wrestling? And the topic all month long, pitch a gimmick for the gauntlet of gimmicks. We're looking for a brand new gimmick that, you know, I know some students at the House of Glory. Maybe I'll push this the winner of this gimmick tournament onto them. You never know. All right. First up, we got Dr. Liam in the house. Dr. Liam, can you hear me?
I can hear you. Happy Ooh. Nick Patrick's Day, my friend.
Happy Nick Patrick's Day to you. Thanks for sending in so much good stuff that we're watching tonight and just in general.
My pleasure, my friend.
Now, how are you doing tonight?
I'm doing okay. And yourself?
I'm doing great. I've been looking forward to this. Once I made the decision that I'm doing three gimmick shows in a row, and I'm like already getting stuff for all three, I'm like, I'm excited for every week now.
I'm excited for these shows for sure. I was looking forward to this one after sending all that stuff in.
Yes,
it's almost like playing the lotto. Like, is my stuff gonna get picked? You know.
Yes. Now, so do you have something for one of the two topics?
I have two things. For one for each.
Yes.
My luckiest. Well, he wouldn't. I don't know if he wouldn't be classified a wrestler, but a wrestler.
It's luckiest person in pro wrestling. Just to open it up.
Oh, okay. My pick is Paul E. Dangerously, aka Ooh. Paul Heyman.
Really? Because, why would you say he's the luckiest?
Because he's a guy who started out as a scrawny cameraman in like 1980 or 1979, and he's involved to this day in the wrestling business. He's the ultimate survivor.
That's true.
Of the wrestling wars. He's like the only one left from his era that's still really in the business and in a prominent role.
Yeah, at the top of the card. And yeah, you're right. I got some answers from Instagram, and let me just say the people from Instagram are a little more negative than the answer you just gave me.
Oh wow. People being negative on Instagram?
Yes. And so I'll read some of those later, but that's a good one, Paul E, yeah.
And for the gimmick gauntlet, what I have is this could either be called the disgraced congressman Ooh. Or the disgraced like assemblyman, which yes. would be a guy or a woman who got thrown out of office and now they've taken up wrestling to make money, but they act like they have a lot of money and they try to pay people off, but then it turns out that the checks are bouncing. Their money's no good.
I like it. I'm adding it to the list. That's great.
That's all I got.
All right. Well, thank you so much, Crimson Mask Replica on Instagram.
Thank you, brother.
All right. You have a good night.
You too, Scotty.
All right. Thanks for calling. Now, holy moly, Andrew Heelan in the house.
I hear myself.
What's up?
I hear you. You hear me.
Yeah, isn't that nice?
The way communication works.
I'm learning.
Yeah. We all come to the potluck to learn. We get
That's
entertained.
True.
This is where I come to learn.
I learn something new every week. So,
yeah, I've got, I'm going to do both.
And please.
First, I'm going to say luckiest person, and this is, like, really obvious. It's clearly Vince McMahon. He just, like, committed crimes for decades, never went to jail, and became a billionaire. Just luckiest. That's not even close.
All right. Wow. I'm surprised that didn't come up already in the answers I got.
I mean, you can do any of the Nepo babies, of which he is also. So, you know, there's a ton of options. Now, gimmicks.
Yes, right. I know you were excited about this. I know you some.
I got some dandies. All right. Probably some others I forgot because I lost my notes app. I don't know. This ties in to what's happening on an upcoming potluck. Paul Blart clumsy security guard mall cop gimmick.
Wow.
Like, you're the cop, but nobody respects you. Like, you shouldn't because they're cops. And, like, no, you just, like, you're just really bad at your job. Yeah. So, there you go.
Mall cop.
Mall cop.
I love it.
Speaking of cops, 1312, rest in power, Ryan Gaynor. Also, this is going to be a ripped from the headlines gimmick. Ooh. A tag team, the corporate officers, corporate officer number one and corporate officer number two.
I'm writing it down.
Cool. All right. Number three, this is the real winner. Also ties into some current news. Recently announced that Mike Rotunda is going into the world's most worthless Hall of Fame. Probably best known for not his best gimmick, but best known for his character of Erwin R. Scheister, a tax collector.
Yes.
That's passé, man. That's some 1900 stuff. What's going on now? What affects people's pockets now? Student loans. Your character is the student loan collections officer, and your character name is Fannie Mae.
We actually, somebody said something like that last week. They said the collection agency.
All right. Well, I'm narrowing it down.
No, I like that. I'm gonna put Fannie Mae after that in parentheses.
Yeah, because we come to the potluck to learn, and so we're all learning from each other. We're gonna work together to build the perfect character.
All right,
that's it. I got three gimmicks for this week. I'm sure I'll have more by the time I have my next beer.
That's great. All right, thank you so much, Andrew Heelan.
You bet.
All right. Good night. All right. Well, now let me read some of the ones that I have right now. These are some of the luckiest people that people have sent in to me. Gotch Style Bong Rips on Instagram. Great artist. Good follow. He says Dick Togo is the luckiest person just for his name. That's a fun one. ATL Blood Feast in the chat. He says QT Marshall is the luckiest. And I get it. You know, he got the AEW hire because of his Cody thing. And then got some power, allowed to leave, come back, still got a job. La Parka Fan Club on Instagram says Alex, the guy who comes out with Penta, Alex Abrahentes, who really does nothing except jump around. That seems like a great gig. And Jake Bars, who's also in the chat now, sent me on Instagram, David Arquette, for two reasons. Number one, winning the World Heavyweight Championship. And number two, for not dying when he fought Nick Gage. So those are some people's luckiest person in wrestling. Chat is saying Tony Khan. Clint says Hogan. All right. And now let me go to this tournament. This tournament screen. Next week, this is all going to be filled. I'll have four quadrants. All these will be filled. I'll be having people vote on them, at least on Instagram. I might put some polls in the chat during the show and just really get this done. But at this time, before we move on, here's some of the... Here's the list of all the gimmicks I have so far. And actually, let's get to the big screen for this. I don't need the tournament there. If you're going to send... This is what I want in the future. for these remaining ones. Get weird. Think about the gimmicks that are around. Not occupational. Let's get even weirder than occupational gimmicks for these last ones. There's people whose gimmick is that they, you know, is a SNL sketch. You know what I mean? John Morrison's gimmick was that he was Jim Morrison. That's weird. So let's get weird like that. Hey, Cool Dude Food is in the chat. Owen Straw.
Attention, Owen Straw.
All right. So here's all the gimmicks that I have. That some were said on the telephone. Some I got through Instagram, text message even. Doorman, comedian, a baker, a podiatrist, the Seven Deadly Sins, the collection agency, a divorced dad, a magician, a disgraced assemblyman, Paul Blart, and corporate officers 1 and 2. So those are the ones I got through the phone. Now here's all the other ones that you haven't heard yet. We have a toxic gamer, a candlestick maker who would go against the baker, no doubt, a radical feminist, a bird watcher, a nice guy, that's not gonna be my gimmick, mama's family as a gimmick, right? Right? A mama's family gimmick? Can you imagine if just like Liv Morgan just dressed like mama's family? That would literally be my favorite wrestler. Big baby. Movers. A shepherd. Someone with OCD. A mother-daughter tag team that just argues. The grammar hammer. A frogman of the military. And a frogman the animal, a telemarketer, Lupin the Third, and Bernie from Weekend at Bernie's. All right, there you go. The chat's giving me some, but I'm not taking it from the chat. You should have called me. Let's see, there are some good ones in the chat. Let's see. Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba. Competitive eater. All right, I'll get to those. All right, let's get back to the action / Nick Patrick promos. Oh, hold on, hold on. Earlier in our timeline. This should have been played earlier. I apologize. The timeline!
Or a busted shoulder or something.
Get him out of here!
Our cameraman and the record quick to go back. We are still back now.
He said it, ref. Now look at this interesting referee gear. Vertical stripes, big black stripes on the shoulders, and a bow tie.
Very, very formidable opponents in the ring. Morgan's the Maniac and Mad Dog O'Malley. Mad Dog O'Malley being a
So this is Morgan's the Maniac versus Mad Dog O'Malley in a slam challenge. Now I think YouTube viewer Henrik sent this in. If not, it was Crimson Mask Replica himself, Dr. Liam, but I think this is a Henrik. I don't have my notes for that in front of me.
Dog O'Malley. And I see here at the beginning of the match, he's taking advantage of, I think, the advantage of quickness he has over O'Malley. A quick drop kick, sending him through the bottom two ropes.
Let me tell you something, Steve Lyons. I've been watching Morgan the Maniac for some 5 years now, and I have never seen him throw a drop kick in his life. Maybe he's decided to throw the strength aspect away and catch him by surprise for the slam.
This is the weirdest referee gear.
Morgan the Maniac is the current MEWF champion. Morgus has some phenomenal stamina and resilience. Great sums of punishment. I think
going for the slam, Morgus the Maniac, not so smart.
He's going to need as much much resiliency and endurance as he possibly can muster. I don't think he's ever faced a man with quite the curse.
Oh, hold on. I got to stop the cat from eating the other cat's food.
Morgan's went for the quick slam, and I think a little bit premature in the matchup, having not worn down Mad Dog enough. And now the advantage gained by Mad Dog. A couple of big forearms, clubbing blows to middle of the back, keeping Morgan on the mat.
Well, Steve Lyons, I would have to say that Mando O'Malley is the number one contender to the MEWF title. We could see the title change hands here tonight. After all, Mad Dog O'Malley is currently undefeated.
Well, normally that might be the case, Mike, but in this match, the stipulations say that it is a non-title matchup.
But maybe he has a point in that if O'Malley can pin Morgan here, they can get a rematch for that heavyweight championship.
I think that he'll get an automatic title match in the event he does get some kind of pinfall or submission victory here. But I think Mike Nichols is right on target. This could signify the end of the title reign for Morgan the Maniac. It may not be this evening. It could be tomorrow night or next week, but it could definitely happen. Right.
Sorry about that. These cats are bad.
On top of a man like Morgan.
Morgan has faced many big men, many strong men in his career. But
all right, so this confirmation, this was sent in by Henrik on YouTube, not Dr. Liam.
As large as Mad Dog O'Malley is, so I'd have to imagine probably not, at least not in a wrestling ring, Mike Nichols.
That's for sure. Mad Dog O'Malley
Mike Nichols.
Claims to be unslammable.
Nichols and May?
Now how can someone claim to be unslammable, Steve Lyons?
I'm not too sure. I guess he's saying that his size and the advantage he's got with his strength.
That is a weird way to hit someone with a chair, an open chair, corner of the chair.
That he won't be able to make a slam. As you know, you need all the back strength you can handle in order to slam any man, a normal 225-pounder, let alone somebody that's 459 pounds.
Well,
using a chair to his advantage, taking the back out, there's no leverage that Morgan can have to pit the slam a man like Mad Dog.
We should have bet on this one.
Has yet to be involved in a lengthy match, totally overpowers his opponents, totally destroyed the clown, if you remember that match.
Are you mad, Bob?
This match is going to be 4 minutes. And Morgan, however, likes the lengthier matches. The longer the match goes, as you pointed out with the endurance...
Mad Dog into the corner, goes Morgus, Morgus splash.
Morgus the Maniac has the
goes outside on that one.
And certainly...
top rope elbow!
But that's totally another story.
Beautiful flying shoulder tackle, but the girth of the big man can't take him down. He's going to have to go after his legs. His knees obviously have to be a little weaker. If he's going to take him down, he's got to go downstairs.
I'm impressed by the return burst of energy.
Sam Cedar on commentary, yeah.
The floor so many times in that chair. Coming back now to go after
him. Picks him up!
Ooh. It's for the Tent City Championship.
Mad Dog O'Malley hitting Morgan from behind. You know, Morgan is probably one of the
really does sound like Sam Cedar.
Setting him up for that big splash. There it is.
There it was.
Oh, forget about it.
Wait. He pinned him, but doesn't he need to slam him to win? Oh no, Morgus the Maniac. You know, these maniacs, they don't take losses very well. Where are we at? This is more acting from Sheamus somewhere coming up in this dark clip. There he is. Hey, Vinnie Jones is in this. He's making caveman noises.
Fella. Too many limes.
Ishka.
Is this Harry and the Hendersons? Seamus and the Hendersons.
Have a drink on me. And a smoke while you're at it.
He had time to do two one-liners. A two-liner, in fact.
There's someone that's sending a message to the NWO.
Yeah, there is no question. Diamond Dallas said he just had arrived to view this next matchup. One of our most
our second Nick Patrick match Patrick on this Nick Patrick's day.
Randy Anderson
be an embarrassment to his
well,
family.
Tony, this should be
Mama's
a very interesting
cry.
Matchup.
The babies
of course,
are going to
seen
cry.
Nick Patrick involved
Randy Anderson's
in a matchup
whole family's
with Chris
be
Jericho,
crying
where
tonight.
Jericho actually had his
Randy
hand tied behind his back.
Nick Patrick.
But if Nick Patrick is looking past Randy Anderson, he may be
a referee with earrings. Now I've seen it all.
Allstate in Georgia, he was never pinned.
Matt Steele, you said it, man.
Yeah, but you're
he's rebelling against
now.
His
yeah,
parents, against the spoiler.
That guy wants to keep him from working. He's talking about
or the assassin.
He's
my
got
mistake.
Going on inside of him right now. I don't care what great amateur background he had. He's nervous. I'll guarantee it right there.
And you can better believe Randy Anderson. Although it takes
wow, Randy Anderson getting the pyro. They were really wasting money.
It's a fight for family, and like I said, very much like the Piper situation, when you face a man who is fighting for the honor of his family, it's a
all right, ref versus ref.
Well, he has his young daughter, Montana, his son, Chase, wife, Christy. His
look, three different referee gears represented here.
Dad's job is at stake tonight.
Absolutely, here we go. And he better finish him off quick, because I understand that TV is rented.
All right, he is being handed something here.
Who is this guy?
Uh-oh, here we go.
Oh, yeah, fight fire with fire. Jimmy Jett handed him something.
Jimmy Jett. A WCW official,
yes,
right?
Yes, he is.
Jimmy Jett.
He's got his glass on. He don't think he'll get hit. Well, keep him on. He might not hit you.
If he connects with this, and that's a big question if.
Look, Pee Wee's just measuring him. He's just measuring him right now. He's waiting for his opening.
They're standing here chanting Randy's name.
They're chanting for Randy Anderson, the referee. Ooh!
Down he goes! Randy Anderson came prepared! 1, 2, 3!
He cheated!
Randy Anderson wins!
He cheated!
No more helper for the family. He's got
Randy Anderson can't work!
The can of beans.
Oh man.
Absolutely. Scrape up Nick
Drat.
Patrick, he's done.
Next year.
Oh, here comes the ball.
Next year. Next he Nick Patrick's mad. Day. I'll be hard pressed to find Nick Patrick stuff. I'm playing it every time he talks tonight.
No, it's not going to be. What do you think you're doing?
Look at this. Look at his mullet.
You knocked him out. What is this?
Disgraced
what
vitamin
that?
Salesman. That's that's
you
what Bischoff looks like.
That. You used to be a referee.
Hey, he won the match.
You used to be a referee.
Used to be is the word.
You won nothing. And you, I saw it. Let me tell you what you won. No. You just won a permanent vacation, and you
sweet.
Are fired. Fired.
Wow.
Disgraced vitamin salesman. Yep. It's going on the list. Why not?
Leave the building.
I got to get to 32.
Now. You're fired.
He can do whatever he wants, I guess.
The man's power hungry. That is not fair.
It's a very
and take those with you.
It's a very sad case.
I hate Eric
for
Bischoff
sports.
So much.
Patrick is still out.
Yes.
Get the wheelbarrow. Time to take him home.
He has like an 80s voice. I can't describe it, but he has like an 80s quality to his voice, like Garfield or Alf, but he's not cool like Garfield and Alf. He sucks.
Messing with people's lives.
You're not kidding, he is.
The following contest has
oh, hold on. I gotta fast forward to this entrance.
And it is
we'll
set
be
for one
right. Second to last match, or close to it. Last match might be very short. This was sent in by Crimson Mask Replica on Instagram. We know him as Dr. Liam in the chat. Session Moth Martina. Irish chick. Audio is crazy loud. Let's get it down. It's the music. Thanks for letting me know. Session Moth Martina versus Maki Ito. Now, I don't know a ton about Session Moth Martina. We might have watched one of her matches on the potluck in the past, and I think that might have been my only knowledge. So Session Moth means she parties. Yep, I think, yes. I believe that's why this was sent in. Clint, I need to buy another thing before I can use the Stream Deck. I need to buy a powered, what's it called, thing for plugging in multiple objects. And then it's over. But I don't have a job currently, so I'm waiting. Something to plug into the USB-C that I can plug in multiple things to it. A powered USB-C hub. Yes, sir. That's what I need. Because I have a USB-C hub, but it's not powered. So it didn't work when I tried it out. But I'm going to get one. And then it's over for all these fools. Yeah, that's going to be a game changer, and I'm sorry I sat on it for months, but the Stream Deck will change this game that we call Potluck, folks.
So don't let her sweet exterior fool you. She will literally look at you and kill you.
Yeah.
See, she's just making us win.
That's what rock stars do.
Exactly, that's right.
And there she is.
All right, Maki Ito. I could not plug it in directly.
I think Martina.
Because I have one USB-C hub in, and then I have the power in. I looked it up, they said you need a powered one.
Oh, I love it.
Turning it up a little bit for this Maki Ito performance. Session Moth Martina dancing her ass off in the corner. Vinny Lex, thanks for subscribing. Referee Vinny Lex gifting subs. No, it doesn't. It does not.
Oh, I don't think Sasha Moth is happy with the cutest girl in the world. Oh, here goes the chat. Can't help but sing with the cutest in the world.
The UK, they really have that hive mind chanting going.
There we go.
There she is.
Don't worry about it. Yeah, I looked it up. I tried a few different things.
Vicinity. Exactly. And if you're watching on Fight TV, I'm sure you can find her.
Hey, come here.
Look at the focus of Maki Ito's eyes there. Oh.
Oh. Is she going to take Maki on the sesh?
Is she going to bring her into the sesh? Oh!
Thank you, referee Vinny Lex.
Maki Ito's not very happy, but Sesh and Moth is living for it.
I appreciate it.
That's the match now started.
I do not have a job right now. I'm hustling for my money, so I appreciate every subscription and all that jazz.
Oh!
Well, this is a fun match. They're dancing.
Check me, Papa.
Oh, not anymore.
Ooh.
That's what I'm saying. I've watched a bunch of videos on the Stream Deck, and I cannot wait. It's going to be dope. I have it right here at my desk.
Big coming forward to the throne there of Maki Ito.
Look at this.
Oh, lovely elbow there to Sasha Moth.
Just you wait. Just you wait, potluck viewer.
Oh. Oh. Take a drink. Sasha Moth in a wee bit of a breather. Maki knows something's up.
Oh!
Oh no, she's made Maki Ito cry!
Oh, why would you do that, Sasha Moth?
You know, hey, yeah, smart tactics there from Sasha Moth, blind your opponent, but when you make them cry, she's the cutest girl in the world. You don't spit beer in her face.
She's crying.
Oh, no.
Say you're sorry. Great chant.
I mean, having beer or any type of alcohol in your eyes is not nice whatsoever, so her eyes must be stinging.
The 5 o'clock somewhere match. Oh. Can somebody send that to me? That sounds right up our alley.
Taking Martina over.
She misses with the headbutt, one of my favorite moves.
Martina's like, you're not doing that again to me. You know what? She's got 70 kids. She knows these tactics, bro.
She does.
Now Martina, like I said, is just off a big tour in Japan there recently.
Oh,
she literally
shit.
Only
okay.
has had a day
I gotta
break.
Find that.
Then she said to me she only had 2 hours sleep.
I think we know where we're going for here. Is she gonna go for that Bronco Buster?
She going for it?
Bronco Buster!
She hits it! Sasha Moth just loving life in the corner.
Oh wait, hang on a second. Is Maki okay? You gotta pull her out the corner, ref. She
just
the
bucking the Bronco right in the face of Maki Ito.
Oh, no, oh no. Oh, that tells me something that's not good. It's not good to be there.
Oh no. I mean, she's had beer in her eyes. I mean.
And she just had Martina right there. It's like.
I mean, this
it's an effective move for Martina. You have to give it to her.
This match
I think Maki Ito's knocked out.
I don't think Maki knows what she's coming for.
Body hit! To the face of Maki.
Oh my god.
Okay. The only person that
crotch
can
to the face.
Martina.
Oh, she sneaks out, finds the back door right in the asshole.
Right, get a hit in the bum.
dumb. You wouldn't think it's effective, but it really is.
Yeah.
Because you get Charlie horses and everything like that. It's insane.
Pussy versus Breezango. Now that's potluck stuff. Fashion Police, one of my favorite gimmicks. You've heard me talk about how much I love Fashion Police.
You gotta remember, Maki Ito has one of the hardest heads in wrestling today. So that was an unwise tactic from Martina there.
Pussy versus Maximum Male Models, MXM. We watched that on the Buzz Bowl, I believe. I think that was the last Buzz show I did. I'm overdue for an all Buzz show, folks.
She goes, no, you
know,
that's how it might be.
Maki Ito was trying to steal Martina's beer. You don't come between her and her beer. No, yes, no. Ooh. Oh!
She's saying, she goes,
Is that gonna, oh, she feels the fuel, she feels the fire.
You do not give children sweets because they get so hyped up.
Oh, hang on, but she's never drank before. The thing is, so Maki's.
Oh no, she's drunk.
Oh dear.
Yeah, it's hit her.
She's drunk in a match.
It's nearly 10 minutes left in this match.
What is this, ECW? What is this, Al Snow's OVW, where people wrestle under the influence of drugs and alcohol?
Oh, you know what? Maki's still going. Maki's on the piss. Oh, no, it's going
to drop. This is great. Thank you, Dr. Liam, for sending this in. A little comedy.
So hashtag can't have to set.
Ooh, catches the arm. Oh, DDT on Session Moth Martina Maki Ito.
The sash.
Drunken master indeed.
Oh, no, reverse by Martina, throwing her straight into the corner. Oh,
she's got her.
She's
got a puke. She's got a puke.
What does Maki Ito have left? Maki never forgets the fans. Oh, is she going to do it herself?
Here she goes.
Come on. Session with Martina, rights and lefts.
Man. Trying to give Martina a hangover.
Literally. And I'm pretty sure she hasn't happened in a very long time.
Oh,
no.
the headbutt,
the best headbutt in wrestling.
Downstairs, you know, before
teams. Two. Dose.
So get it, training guys. Can Maki Ito handle this? Yes,
Kokeshi.
No.
The Kokeshi headbutt.
She's handling it pretty well. She's handling it better than what I would
have. Double chop.
Oh! Big enziguri there from Martina.
But as you see, it just clipped her on the cheek there.
Oh, nice suplex. With a twist. Two.
Suplex. Martina kind of a wee bit shocked right now. She's dead, swinging a miss, and a sidekick.
Ooh, the hard head of Maki Ito. Hurts the ankle of Martina.
Just got her in the eyes there. Off the ropes. But get up.
Another DDT.
Back in the center of the ring. Setting her up. Lovely awareness there from Maki Ito. What is she going for?
Far away, but Maki Ito does not care.
Up to the top.
Top rope.
Ooh. Headbutt
from the top.
Two. We are just down to 8 minutes left. Just under 8 minutes left.
Oh, there's a time limit in this.
She lifted her up. Is she going to go for that clover leaf?
Texas clover leaf.
Beautiful.
And the knee done. Dropping. Oh, Martina tapped.
She tapped out. Your winner, Maki Ito.
What a debut for Maki Ito. Launches an
But my sources are telling me we must watch this promo.
Sources. I think Maki just proved to Martina that she can definitely handle the sesh.
Well, my sources.
And the thing is,
though,
I think the thing that Martina is going to take away is don't hit Maki Ito in the head. She's the hardest head in the business, and she is the cutest girl
the
in the world.
The hardest
she is.
Martina's already like, don't come get me. Going back to your favorite, the beer.
drinking, taking the lost heart. Great face from Session Martina.
Martina liking it though.
Give her the mic, goddammit! Come on! Don't you all understand? This is the
Oh, she's trying to stop the music.
Hello, motherfuckers.
You know what? I think she likes. You know what? She has a place here in the Bad Girls of Wrestling right now.
Yeah.
They're officially better than the three places
on Demand at EveOnDemand.pivotshare.com so you can catch up with all the goings on here.
They have
at
more
Eve,
than one
Ragnos
mic. Wow, I'm telling you. All right.
Involved in the world heavyweight
blast from the past right here.
Between Dusty Rhodes and Ric Flair. And Nick, first of all, welcome to the program. But secondly, a rather heavy responsibility fell on your shoulders during that match.
Well, thank you very much, Gordon. What happened is the NWA always appoints two referees to watch over world championship matches. And during the match, Ronnie West was the original referee. He was struck, he was knocked down. So I jumped in the ring and continued the match. During the match, Dusty had Ric Flair down close to the ropes. I dove in and I made the 1-2-3 count. When Dusty got up, I saw that Ric Flair had his feet on the ropes. So I told him to continue the match. Dusty thought that he had won. He went over, he had the belt in his hands. Rick. I was telling him to continue the match. When Ric Flair come to him, Dusty hit him with the belt, knocked him out. He was seriously injured, so I had no other choice but to disqualify Dusty Rhodes.
Well, that was certainly understandable, and I think, too, it's important to note that...
Now, the comments on this YouTube video say that this was after the original Dusty finish.
With the adrenaline flowing like that, it's certainly understandable how somebody could misunderstand, particularly in a moment of jubilation, like thinking that he'd re-won the title.
Yes, sir. It was a very grueling match for both men, so I can realize where Dusty was confused, because he did hear the three count. However, Flair's feet were on the ropes.
Which, of course, automatically calls for a break. And, of course, when they got back on their feet, as you said, Dusty had the belt. He thought he had won it. And when Ric Flair charged him, he really reacted instinctively, did he not?
Yes, sir. He struck him with the belt, and that was automatic grounds for disqualification.
And I might just point out that that's exactly what did happen. Now then, we do
it's
have
from
some
the original
comments
Dusty
from
finish.
The NWA World
Dr. Liam backing me up.
Mr. Ric Flair concerning the situation.
You know, I always referred to myself as the greatest from the time I was old enough to spell my name. From the time I was old enough to really know who I was and what I was doing. I've always called myself the greatest because I was the best athlete in high school. I had all the girls. I had the nicest clothes. I had all the luxuries that anybody of my talent and my ability deserved. Then I started professional wrestling. And a lot of people said, you think that that young kid is going to be the greatest wrestler of all time like he tells everybody he is?
Well, I love that belt.
Look at me now. Still a young kid. In the prime of my life. Still wearing the finest clothes. And still knocking the women dead.
Say what?
Only one addition. I'm the world's heavyweight champion. And I didn't buy this. And this beautiful face and all these fine clothes didn't bring me this. Solid wrestling ability. The ability to be a man above and beyond. 120% gut check brought me this. And I'm going to hang on to this for a long, long time. And those of you out there that doubt my durability or my lasting power, you just keep watching TV week in and week out. Because Ric Flair, the Nature Boy, woo, the living legend, is going to be the holder of this 10 pounds of gold for a long, long time. Only one thing left in life. And that's to hear them all say someday, Ric Flair was the greatest champion in the history of wrestling.
There's people that say that.
Tell me that all over the country now.
Whoa, another promo?
They're having a problem in the classroom.
No, we can't.
Television made professional wrestling popular, particularly in Britain. Since the 60s, occasional tours have taken place to this country. The latest one stopped in Cavan last night. Adults paid £4 and children £2.50 to see the entertainment. But how about the often voiced suspicion that wrestling is fixed?
You know, it looks, there's a lot of showmanship, like it looks as if it might be unbelievable, but they don't understand that the man on the floor has only been hit hard enough just to knock the wind out of him.
The final bout of last night, a tag match, featured a County Mayo man called Giant Haystacks.
There's Haystacks.
He's 7 foot tall, 40 stone weight, and proved to be the most popular entertainer in Cavan. Sure, I suppose at the worst of times, it makes a bit of a change from a touring circus.
All right, this is our main event. It is Nick Patrick's day, so this is the main event. Will this even make it to YouTube? Will this make it to YouTube? It's already on YouTube, but I get worried when it's in decent quality. I used to have that WCW shirt with the weird logo. They were the officials, the referees going at it in the locker room area. Nick Patrick can be extremely biased in these sort of situations. What is this all about? I'd like to give the guy the benefit of the doubt, but this guy gives officiating a bad name. That looked like a quick count to me, JR. You're damn right it was a quick count. Shady officiating by Nick Patrick. How can you allow this to happen? What can I do? What can you do? I'll tell you what you can do. You can stand up for yourself, man. You can run over to Nick Patrick's dressing room now. You can kick the door. This is going to be good. This is our main event, folks. Our third Nick Patrick match of the evening. We have watched more Nick Patrick than Fit Finley on this day. I can't believe this is our main event, but that's where we are at. And the referee for this referee versus referee match is Mick Foley, who has worked all over the world. He has no biases. The theme of this show, it's Nick Patrick's Day. And then I also got sent a bunch of Irish stuff. Mick Foley has surprised us all. We didn't know Mick was even So this isn't on pay-per-view. This is on the Heat. Or this is on whatever the pre-show.
Nick Patrick's got some dope music, huh?
This is the pay-per-view. Okay, so this people paid for this.
Pre-show, Chavo versus Scotty. Wowee. They had the pre-show. This goes on the main show, of course.
Nick was there, and then he was in ECW for a while, and of course, his legend grew to worldwide status here in the WWF.
Representing the WWF.
In the business, and he is loyal. He bleeds WWF blood.
Well, Nick Patrick as well, extremely loyal to the WCW as these two men go face to face and begin the jaw jacking.
Ooh, push to Nick Patrick. Ooh, big right hand.
Nick Patrick, have you ever seen anything like this, Jay?
Absolutely not.
Big kick. Throws him into the corner. Yeah, Hebner and his brother are going to be selling bootleg merch in the parking lot. Oh, big back bump. Two count only, says referee Mick Foley. WWF blood. That sounds like a disease. I'm sorry, he died. He had WWF blood. He had too many somas in his system. Sabrina, get away from the stuff, please.
WWF officials protecting their senior official Hebner's. WCW referees made their way toward Earl.
I love how the refs are on the outside for this. It's like a lumberjack match of referees. Earl Hebner lighting him up with that baby face fire that we get from an aging referee. A lumber ref match. Thank you, Dr. Liam. Brian's saying this should end with a sharpshooter. I see stunner. For some reason, I see a stunner. Nice. Sliding kick. The ref's putting the boots to Hebner. Dave in Syracuse checking in. Earl is throwing some good punches. Foley keeping order. Throwing away these invasion referees, the Alliance referees. Oh, that's awesome. Referee Vinny Lack says, a buddy of mine got to toss Hebner out of a ring. Kind of jealous about that.
Earl Hebner slowly making it to his feet. Nick Patrick jaw-jacking with Mick Foley. Look at Earl!
Oh, collision! Pounce!
There's two! He got him! Earl Hebner!
Earl Hebner with the pounce! Somebody has an Earl Hebner sign. Are you serious? Earl Hebner wins this main event, our main event of the evening. maybe the shortest main event in potluck history. But is that so wrong? Tim White in the house. Earl Hebner wins on Nick Patrick Day. Well, you know, Nick Patrick, he's a heel. He's gotta go down. Nick Patrick, three matches tonight, lost all three. Patrick goes flying.
I think we made there it is. It's been buried in Brutal alone. There's Sacco. Mr. Sacco has come out of mothballs. Mr. Sacco, smack in the mouth of Nick Patrick.
The second official has come out, and his name is Mr. Sacco. One day we'll have an all ref appreciation show. We'll figure out what to do for that, but a ref appreciation show would be great. All right, there you go. Next week, Potluck Mall Madness. Be there. This was great. Thank you so much, folks, for tuning in, watching live, or if you're watching in the future on YouTube, thank you so much. And I hope you had a great Nick Patrick's Day. This was wonderful. Thank you, folks, for sending stuff in, always taking submissions. Either DM me over at Mr. Green Mist on Instagram or email me, prowrestlingpotluck@gmail.com. Thanks for watching. Thanks for subscribing, for the subscribers, Referee Vinny Lax, gifting subs. I appreciate it. The Suzanimal always helping out as well. That's that, folks. Next week, Mall Madness, 2 weeks, save my YouTube show. It's going to be wild. It's going to be crazy. Everybody have a good weekend. Have a good week. Good night.